Hello everyone, Michael here from the Daily Note. So I finally received the Android 4.4 update on my Samsung Galaxy Note 2. Although the update from 4.3 to 4.4 seemed like a minor one at first, I found a lot of cool stuff that many of you should find worthwhile. So let's take an in-depth look at what this update brings to your Galaxy Note 2.
Today, let's focus on the updates to the multi-window feature because there are a lot of changes. First, you will notice that the cascading function is now present, just like on the Note 3. If you stack apps on top of each other on one side, you can hit this button, and you can flip through apps that you've opened previously on that side. Next, another update that applies to the updated multi-window is that it now supports multiple instances for the apps that support it. One of those apps is Chrome. You can open Chrome for the top and bottom and have them work independently. When you have multiple instances open, you can select it in the multi-window bar and select or close a specific instance. Another update that you'll see is that when you try to expand the window fully by dragging all the way up or all the way down, is that it won't maximize the window anymore. If you drag it to the bottom, you'll see it only goes to about 80%. Try to drag it all the way again and it goes a little bit more to 90%. After that, it won't go any further. If you want to maximize it fully, you can do it by interacting with the blue dot. Next, another big update in my opinion is the ability to have pairing of apps, again just like the Note 3. For example, maybe you like catching up on TV shows and surfing the web. Well, you can pair it by having the two apps open and selecting the Create button. And next time you want to open those apps side by side, it will open them. And it looks like it saved the sizing as well. Next, some of your stock apps on your Note 2 have been quietly updated with drag and drop features. The official gallery app now supports images being dragged out from it, just like on the Note 3. And the email, messaging, and SNote can now have images and possibly more things dragged into it. Other apps that I know of that support drag and drop are Evernote and Photodesk. If you know of others, please let me know in the comments. Just an additional tip, although it is not a new feature, even if the app doesn't support special drag and drop functionality, most apps that let you select text should let you at least drag the text to any input field in most apps. And last one for today, since we're on the topic of stock apps, an update I'm seeing for the first time is when you crumple the SNote by pinching with three fingers, not two, not four, but exactly three fingers, you'll see it crumple. The crumpling animation is not new, but this animation of it rolling away is new. And here's a nice touch, the paper will fall to the direction that your Galaxy Note 2 is tilted towards. Anyway, this update is pure fun, but I love it.
So that's it for today. I bet you were thinking everything was basically the same after the update, right? Well, this is just part one of at least four videos I have planned for what's new in Android 4.4 for your Samsung Galaxy Note 2. I'm going to try to put out the next video as soon as possible, most likely tomorrow. So make sure to stay tuned, like, subscribe, and check out my other videos on the Galaxy Note 2 and 3 on my channel. And as always, thank you for watching.